Just one more small note. And we got a roaming guard. Why not, right? Let's get a roaming guard on the wasteland. At least I'm not seeing anyone running. Whoa, 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 whoa. So scary. So scary. Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of 7 Days to Die Modded. We are playing Ravenhearst. Let's continue from where we left off. Day 51, almost 11 AM, and we have a very nice episode ahead of us. First off, before leaving my base, let me pick up just preparing for where we are going. I will take some extra healing items and I will get the gun repair kit, which is just to repair my sniper, which is done. So first off, my friends, it's 11, almost 11, because I have recorded played a little bit between episodes offline, recording what I was doing, because since after each hard night the trader resets at least somewhat, I went to the four traders that we have present in our map to see if there was any good stuff. And I'm very glad that I did decide not to make a full episode out of it, because it was very, very crappy. And I'm going to show you guys just what I got in the traders. And it was just to buy something, because clearly nothing amazing. Combat axe, steel shovel, spaghetti, and a skinning knife. Four traders, secret stash all over the place, but just these four tools. I'm going to introduce right now a video of a small resume of my travelings to the traders and buying these items.
Get you today. You need assistance?
Greetings, stranger. I've got the best deals in Mavis Gain. Thank you.
And now, as you have seen in the video, clearly that resume, it's more than enough to see what I was getting on the traders. And you also saw in the video right at the end, the last trader, it had three small safes, and I used my tools to open the safes, and we got some nice gun parts. But again, nothing amazing. We got a lot of dollar bills that I already sold for coins at the same trader. In this chest, ignoring these four items that I have bought on the trader, we have the loot from the last Fortnite, at least the better part of it, and not as good as the previous horde loot wise, but we still got some good things. A lot of quests, some parts of military armor. We got a baseball bat, not that it's amazing, but it's what you need to make Lucille, so it's good, always good to get a baseball bat. Some supply flares, parts of the compound bow, a full compound bow, a full crossbow, ammo supply box, a lot of ammunition, grenades, which I have to try, a rocket propelled grenade, some rounds, some ammunition. Ammunition wise, it was not bad. Overall, finish loot from the Horde Knight. Spaghetti wise, I did not mention why I did buy the spaghetti. I was checking at the trader. Look at this, 55 fullness plus 1.2 wellness. I need to check what do I need to make the spaghetti. Well above my previous item for wellness. I need to check what do I need for the spaghetti. Perhaps some crazy stuff that it's not easily available, but I bought the spaghetti just to remember myself that I need to explore even more the recipes. So let me check the notes. I think I have covered everything. We are more than ready to go. We will today go for the first time on this let's play, explore the wasteland. I want to try to find the diamond nodes, and the copper and zinc that I saw in the release notes that are available in that biome. So we are going to explore this wasteland biome here. And I have checked, and since I travel this road over here while going back and forth to the traders, the nodes that we want, it's these ones, diamond nodes and zinc nodes. So if you find on your map this small cross or half a cross, it's what we want. So one good way to find the nodes without getting too much distraction in the wasteland, it's travel with your mini bike and then go to a safe place, check the map, find those crosses, and then go back again after marking with, for instance, the quick waypoint. So let's get started. We will explore a little bit the wasteland, try to get a little bit of diamonds. We'll try not to die, always a good thing to do. Hopefully it all goes down well and we find some diamond nodes and some zinc and some copper. And let's get going. First off, we are going to check the airdrop, which I think it was on the previous or a couple of days ago. It was one of the days that I was building my base, preparing my base for the Horde Knight, and I marked the airdrop because I did not have time to go there. So let's check the airdrop. It's close by. It should be around here somewhere. Let's see if we are lucky with the drops. Good loot. Not that amazing. Hoping for a beaker. And let's go to the wasteland. I will mark over here. It's going to be our first stop. We are going to explore a little bit that area. And that area where I marked the quick waypoint, It's somewhere around there that I want to make a small mine outpost. I know that you guys told me that if you want diamonds, you should look on the surface for the nodes, and probably are the best choice. But I also want a mining outpost because it's near several biomes, that area, and I want to mine, for instance, for more resources. But I also want on the top area to make some small towers where I can hunt the nightmares, because I think the nightmares are also tied to the biomes, and since we are in on the forest biome, which should be the easiest one nightmare wise, I want to know what the game has to offer in these rougher biomes. So around here somewhere I would like a flat area if possible. If not, I will handle it. But in this area here, for instance, near the wasteland forest, burned and very easy to access the desert. So hopefully while exploring I will remove the fog of the map and find a nice place. So let's get started. Hopefully I won't get murdered by dogs or ferals or whatever. I don't know by heart the changes that they made in the wasteland. Okay, I'm not seeing nothing amazing, but I'm seeing a backpack. And I always like the backpacks. So let's continue. Some POIs. Let me know. Are these POIs good enough, or have good rewards to loot them, or I should stay away from them? I don't recall seeing them anywhere else, this kind of building. Okay, but let's not get sidetracked. Let's try to find, well, it's right there. I think it's over there. Yeah, no, yeah, yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's one of these kind of nodes right here to my right might have diamonds there. Okay, but of course I need some breathing space, and I'm not going even to be joking around here. It's going to be sniper rifle for everybody. Come on. And that's one of the diamond ones. Nice, nice. We already found what I was looking for. And you are down. You are down. You are down. Okay. Just one stripper. I don't know what she's doing on the way to the biome. Okay. Are we? No, we are not. Now we are. Okay. Anyone else? I'm hearing someone very near. Okay. And okay. Come on. Okay, let's get started, shall we? In this case, these nodes, we get zinc and a little bit of a chance to get something else. We got already a gold nugget. And let's catch this guy. Give me my shovel, which I should have done this before. And a little bit of copper, I think. This node is done. Let's get to the diamond one, which is over there. Here it is. No ferals, no bears, no nothing. And we can start. We get started on this. These ones can give you diamond, but they are, they have a lot of hit points. One silver nugget, also a chance. Smash these guys. Hopefully. Let's get back to business. It's going to be a mining diamonds episode. Hopefully we'll get some diamonds out of. I'm keeping an eye out on my top right corner to see if we get some diamonds. But I need also another silver. But I also need to be on the lookout for zombies. And one lady over here. Hello. Always hoping for a dead and elusive beaker. One diamond, my friends. One diamond. Okay, I don't know if the quality of the tool you get more diamonds or not. And we should drink some coffee. Even if the diamond pickaxe drains much less your stamina, if you keep doing this long enough, you will get your stamina down. Always on the lookout. You can get cops very easily on the wasteland, and ferals, and running ferals. So you should always be looking for them. We shall continue. Of course, clearly, if we had an auger, that would be the best use of the auger. It would be on this kind of mining. We are on the wasteland, a very, very dangerous biome. So the auger, since it's very fast, we should use it. But we don't have yet the number of auger parts to make the schematic. We got in the last episode 2 more. We are missing 1 to make the regular auger, and we are missing 2 for the steel auger. And even that, I don't really know by heart. What do we need to make an auger? But I think some parts of an auger we need to loot them. I cannot make all of them. So, but that's going to be the second stage. The first stage is to get the schematic of the auger, which we don't have yet. So. Little bit boring. I don't know, my friends. Let me know. I clearly think coming to the wasteland, having our mini bike blown up by a mine, getting our ass handed to us by a feral or a cop, clearly warrants recording of the video to get to the wasteland and catch diamonds. But if you don't think that it's worth it, let me know and I might do this offline. But I really think it's worth the video to get to the wasteland for the diamonds. Where? Just one more small note. And we got a roaming guard. Why not, right? Let's get a roaming guard on the wasteland. At least I'm not seeing anyone running. Whoa, 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 whoa. So scary. So scary. You already know how much I love the sniper, right? You probably know. I'm not even going to loot the bodies. I will keep focused on our diamond extraction. One more. And I will not, at least for this episode, we will explore the wasteland more than get the nodes. I will try to mark them on the map the same way as I uncovered this area, but we'll travel a little bit north. I found out while traveling between the traders more areas, and here it is, another one. This one I can get. These ones are the half cross. These ones here are the half cross, like you can see over there. And these ones have zinc and have a little bit of copper. And these ones are very fast. Like you can see here, a couple of smacks and they are done. So if I find these ones on the safe-ish area, we'll try to get. Aye! Come on, man. I know that's Halloween, but I don't want to get scared by a schoolgirl. Shovel. And nope. Okay. Some gold nuggets, silver nuggets, and let's keep exploring. Even if we miss these kind of areas, our, come on, man. Wow, such a lag spike. You easily can, let me mark here, which is around the area that I want to go. Since the mini bike uncovers a wide area, you can, for instance, travel on a higher speed, a speed that you feel comfortable, at least while avoiding the the mines. It's going to be enough to uncover and mark on your map the nodes, so you can travel like this and go check the map on a safe place to find the nodes. Even if you don't spot them while traveling, because I clearly think the most important thing while traveling in the wasteland is avoid mines and avoid the cops. The cops can easily destroy your mini bike with the vomit, and it's something that I sometimes forget. I'm just playing around the cop and trying to avoid his speed, and I forget if he hits my mini bike a couple of hits and can be enough to to destroy your mini bike, and then you are stranded in the middle of the wasteland. To run over the dog, but clearly I last dog. Doggy, doggy, doggy. And while I was going between the traders, like I said, yeah, I saw the mounds, like these ones. So it was something like this. So what we'll do now, I'm not going to stop anymore. I will travel a little bit around, try not to get killed, see if I can uncover a good chunk, a good part of the map, because all of those nodes, if you can spot where the nodes are, you can check the map and then you can find similar places to know where the nodes are. It works exactly the same way like the POIs. So if you like, for instance, the death house of the POIs that has a secret stash and the ammunition boxes, it has a footprint on the map that it's always the same. So it's a matter of losing some time on your map, looking in the uncovered areas for similar houses. And those nodes of the diamonds, it's exactly the same. It's a small cross or a small half cross. If it's a full cross, it's the node of the diamond, though that's a node that it takes longer to break. If it's a half cross, it's the zinc and copper one. You can also get some diamonds out of it, but it's faster to mine. So let's keep exploring. We have full gas. Okay. No cops, which I don't mind. I'm not seeing any nodes, but clearly I will explore for more 4 or 5 minutes, and then we'll get back to our base, and then I will show you guys on the map. Probably we'll have uncovered much more nodes than the nodes that we have seen. But I think this is a good strategy. Goosebumps, my friends. Goosebumps. On this insert swear biome. Another diamond node over here to the left. Okay, very nice. Come on, do not get caught. Okay, somewhere where we can have a nice buff, which is clearly one of the things that I don't want to do on Wasteland. It's to have a nice buff. I don't want to. I prefer to stay dirty. And then just trying to uncover a good chunk. Nice. We almost made a full circle. I will probably end exploring like I am the Wasteland. That I will do probably another diamond here, or it's the same one. No, I think it's a different one. There are two different ones. Exploring like I am, I will probably do that between episodes. Not that amazing. I'm just showing you guys the best way to do it, or how you can do it. But mining, coming here to mine, clearly it's episode worthy. It's very stressful, very, very, it's not a safe thing to do, and if it's not a safe thing to do, we should always record it. So let's go back to my base, going back by the Wasteland, just trying to uncover a little bit more, and we'll check out at the end. Let me see. We got 14 diamonds, my friends. 14 diamonds. Whew. Very, very good. You can. I don't know if I have already speak about it. We are level 66. At level 65, I spent another points in the extra level of the steel tools. So now we can make the 100 level quality, 100 quality steel tools, and that will translate, I think, in the diamond edge ones again level 100. So the only thing that I need to think about is, do I want to spend 10 diamonds getting a level 100 tool, or should I wait for level 150, and so on. Another thing that I wanted to ask you guys, if you are at this stage of the game, my feeling is the diamonds should be used on the diamond pickaxes. Pretty much straightforward. Using them on the shovels or the axe, I think even the order should be pickaxe, shovel and axe. I have a level 300 and something steel pickaxe that I bought on the trader. It's so fast to get wood from the trees, so fast that I don't see that greater advantage of making a diamond edge one and spend the diamonds to do so. The shovel again, it's so fast with the steel shovel that again I don't think, or at least I have some doubts if it's worth it to spend the 10 diamonds to make a diamond shovel. The pickaxe, clearly it does, because it's mining for stone, mining the rocks. I think in that case the bonuses of the several resources that you get, I think they are worth it. The wood, I really don't think so. I might be wrong, my friends. I might be wrong, let me know in the comments. But well, if I had 100 plus diamonds, that in that case the choice would be simple. But since at this stage I don't have that many diamonds, I think I prefer to use them only on the pickaxes. I'm very satisfied with the current shovel, and even I can now make a 100 one, and the steel pickaxe, the steel fire axe that I have, level 350, almost 350, it's more than enough to stop, like I can show you, a couple of smacks, and I get all, of the wood easily and fast. If I pick up the grain alcohol or even coffee, I can get a lot. Can get a lot of wood very easily. Should I spend 10 more diamonds to make an even better fire axe? Perhaps a little bit of an overkill. Might be wrong. Again, haven't tried. Perhaps I should, just to make that decision after. Well, spend 10 diamonds and then compare and say, well, they are worth it or they are not worth it. But the pickaxe, clearly it is. I have been digging around making my tunnel for my mini back entrance, and it's so fast to get to open up the tunnels with the steel pickaxe that it's great. That's clearly great. I will cry when I have to start a new game, because it will take so long again at the beginning. But with the diamond edge pickaxe, it's much more easy. So before ending the episode, a lot of talking again, it has been a long series, and I think it, at least people, if they want to know how Ravenhearts can be played, at least they will search for the episode where I speak about something and they can make up their minds. So map, and easily we are in a safe spot. We can check for good places to mine over here, half across. So zinc and copper, just a quick look. I'm not going to bother you guys much. Diamond, note, full cross. I think it's that easy. You explore again, another one here, diamond, note, I think it's the best way to do it. half a node over here. Diamond one here. We still found a lot. A diamond and a half node over here. Very, very nice. Like I said, you travel around the wasteland, try to map the bigger area possible. And we found 5 nodes, 6 nodes, and then you can plan a little bit better where to go and mine after uncovering it, instead of traveling and trying to do too many things at the same time, avoiding zombies, searching for nodes. If you know where they are, you just mark them and go straight to them and worry about something else. Well guys, for me, wonderful episode. We got 4 silver nuggets. I don't know even if I'm going to do more treasure hunting, because I think this is much better. 6 copper, zinc, 6 gold nuggets, and 14 raw diamonds. It was just a note, 2 notes, I don't remember exactly, but nonetheless, amazing, and reward wise compared with the treasures, I think it's better to go to the wasteland. Again, I'm thinking just right now out of my head. I might be wrong, let me know in the comments. Nonetheless, I hope you have enjoyed. I have more diamonds and I can make more diamond wedge tools, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Until then, thank you.